How can the local government system be changed so that the role of ordinary citizens is not limited to just participating in elections?
That's a very difficult question. There are many ways to involve citizens, and each local authority needs to adapt these ways to their needs. You can involve formal NGOs, non-governmental organizations. You can involve citizens directly, create new forms. You can use online instruments to make the opinions of the citizens count. But you have to do this depending on the team on which you are consulting. You should not expect that the same mechanisms will work for all the themes. And probably what's the most important, you need to give citizens feedback about how you use their contribution. You can't expect them just to contribute and never hear back of what their contribution was used at.
At the moment, involving citizens, especially youngsters, in local government structures in Ukraine is not the norm. In your opinion, should this practice be imposed by the state for law creation, or will it only work if the initiative comes from below?
Well, let's say you can't force citizens to participate, so you can't solve the problem of low participation by legislation. You need to convince people that their voice is important, that their voice counts, and that is in their interest to participate. Now, having some form of legal framework is not a bad idea. Many countries do have, let's say, laws which oblige different institutions, be they ministries, or sometimes less often, even local authorities, to do some consultations on very important issues. I would say the most important is, because we are talking about local authorities and they should be autonomous, is that they understand the need to involve citizens, that they look at the issue at stake, and they adopt the right ways to engage citizens, and that they believe in the process. Because if it's just a legal obligation, a box to be ticked, then it will not work. You need to believe that citizens count, that they are the center of policies, and that you can use their mind, their contribution, their energy to do things better, differently and better.
Is there a secret to motivating people to be more active?
No, what would motivate you to get more involved? It's as simple as that. You live in a big city and you benefit from a number of services, right? You need to be convinced that these services can be improved if you contribute to them. So for this, you need a number of things. You need that the public authorities explain to you in simple terms what this service will do and how it can be improved, and then ask for your opinion, makes you be convinced that your opinion counts, and then gives you feedback. And if you see that, for example, the situation of public transport has been improved because of a participatory process, that you gave your voice and your voice was heard, and something happened afterwards, you may be convinced to continue to participate. So it's just about, you know, trying to show to citizens that it's important for them to get involved in the decision-making processes.
Where do you think it's easier to be active? In big cities, small towns, or even in villages? Is there a correlation between where people live and their level of participation?
Well, normally in small villages. because here, simply, the local authority is closer to citizens. You have more opportunities to meet councillors, maybe the mayor, in informal situations. The services which are provided by small cities are clearer to citizens. And of course, it's just a question of numbers. The contribution of citizens, of each citizen, will count more in a village of 1,000 than in a city of 3 million. That being said, it's important also in big cities to participate. And it's important because even though this, let's say, link with the elected people is less direct and close, the number of services is more important. So you can be involved on more things. There are more services which are offered by the municipality of Kiev than the municipality of 1,000 inhabitants. So it's important to get involved, and it's important for Kiev city to get people involved. And actually, we have helped Kiev city to get citizens involved.
If we go back to local authorities, and you follow the topic of how local self-governments develop, would you say that local governments in Ukraine are open enough? Has the level of openness increased recently?
Well, I think no local authority is open enough. I think all local authorities in all of Europe can do better. Well, there are some models. There are local authorities who try to involve very much. I think there is a lot to do in Ukraine. There is a lot to do because there is no culture of participation and there is no culture involvement. And this is the most difficult thing. You can't change the culture of participation through law. You need to show people that it's important for them to participate. I did see a number of interesting experiences, innovations, and there are a number of towns, villages, and cities who are making efforts in this respect. And actually plan next year to help more cities to create participatory mechanisms. Is that enough? No, it's far from enough.
Does this take a long time to learn, in your opinion?
It never ends. It's a process. It's a process. It's like life itself. You try to do better all the time. I don't think there is, I mean, maybe once we have artificial intelligence and everything is managed online, maybe then you reach a situation where you don't need more participation because everybody will participate, but I don't believe in that. I think, you know, the bond of trust between local authorities and citizens needs to be permanently maintained. They need to talk to each other. Even in the European Union, you know, there are very best statistics concerning trust in local government and in central government. And this can only be changed with a closer link, with more participation. And the quality of the services will improve with participation. And I don't think anyone, any citizen, would say the quality of services in my municipality is sufficient, doesn't need to improve. You can always improve. So you always have a motivation to involve citizens more, and citizens always have a motivation to help local authority to improve the way they do business, the way they exercise public authority, and the way they provide services.
In your opinion, which European or international models are best suited to Ukraine in terms of ensuring citizen participation in local governments?
I don't know, it's up to you to see. I mean, it's up to local authorities here. We have a big, let's say, range of options. As said, you can create, let's say, citizens' neighborhood councils. I know this is, there was a draft law in this respect in Ukraine. You can create thematic councils. For example, if you want to improve water delivery in a city, you can just try to create a special council and involve those associations and citizens who are, let's say, competent and interested in the issue. You can just use online tools. You can just have platforms, general platforms for non-governmental organizations. You can have citizens panels. Now it's a very new and modern way. It's like citizens juries. You get a panel, randomly selected number of, let's say, 12, 20 citizens. You take maybe 1 or 2 days of their life, but you present them information in a very condensed format. And then at the end, they decide about what the municipality can do. This is something that we also sometimes do. So there are many forms. But it's not up to us to tell you what works for you, what you need. It's basically up to local authorities, to citizens, to see what works best.
You are looking at Ukraine from the outside. Is there anything that surprises you about citizen participation in local governments in Ukraine?
Well, there are good things and bad things.
Can you talk me through them?
I think there is a high level of, let's say, patriotic feelings and engagement in Ukraine, which is beyond what I see in other countries. And there are good reasons for this. Then I think all citizens here want to have a better, more modern life and want to have, you know, progress, reforms. I'm surprised after, you know, almost 5 years of reform, how much people still support difficult reform of decentralization. They still support it. And most see benefit from it. We have our opinion polls, and it's very encouraging. In most other countries, you know, citizens get used with the reform and then stop supporting reforms after a short time. Now, the bad things are probably that there is no culture of cooperation. There's no culture of cooperation from public authorities. You know, very often they just decide in their offices, almost on the knees, about a new draft law, about a new draft decision for local by local councils. They adopt them very fast, and they are sure that they solve the problem, and they don't take the time to consult people. Now, this consultation participation takes time and takes resources. We know that. But by simply involving other brains, other, you know, people who know what they need, what they want, who collect information, who process information, and give you answers to your question, it's just the quality of the decision will be better. It's expensive, but it's worth it. The culture of cooperation also lacks at the individual level. Very often I see citizens who are quite individualistic. It's not surprising. I mean, I come from a country which went through the same process. And it takes time to change the culture, to understand that there are common goods. Our apartment, our car is a private good, but the affairs of the town, of the city, of the village are common goods. And common goods, we need to, in common goods, we need to get to invest ourselves. We need to benefit all. We don't need to take the most we can while the others lose. We can, you know, win together. And this culture of cooperation still needs to evolve, I think, in Ukraine.
To summarize, what are the Council of Europe's recommendations for strengthening links between citizens and local authorities?
I don't want to get very technical. We have document, a standard, which was adopted recently by our Committee of Ministers, guidelines for participation of citizens in decision-making processes. We have a recommendation about citizen participation at local level, and we even have a convention, a protocol to the European Charter on Local Self-Government concerning participation at local level. So you'll see there quite a number of guidelines, how this can be conducted, how to start it, how to do it, how to benefit from it. But the main idea, I think, is just, you know, keep this always on the back of your mind when you are a decision maker. It's important to get input from citizens on major decisions, of course, not on every day-to-day decision. But it's important to take the time, invest the time and resources for important decisions to get the feedback from citizens. And you'll make, you know, towns, cities, villages better.